Welcome to Sam Goffen Guitar. Really glad to have you here. If you haven't seen any of the other videos yet, check out loads of them because they're kind of quick lessons up, loads of pedal demos and other things. However, today we are interested in the kind of triumvirate really of classic overdrive pedals. So a Klon, a Tubescreamer, and the Nobels ODR1. Things I'm really interested in here are the gain structure of each pedal, because they're a little bit different. The mids, how pronounced are those mids? We know a Tubescreamer's got quite a mid hump, Klon's got a little bit of one as well, and then we've got the ODR1, which is a bit more transparent. So really interested to see how they all interact there. The other thing I'm really interested in is how they react to picking dynamics. So do they clean up when I'm picking gently and, you know, kind of give it some when I dig in. Playing through the Turok here, the Turok Studio Pro 35 head, and using a lovely Telecaster guitar for the sounds. All right, let's check out these awesome, awesome pedals. This is just the amp. Right, let's go with the Tubescreamer, an 808 style Tubescreamer. Everything at 12 o'clock on all of these. The ODR. And then the Klon, I'm going to put that back into the middle because everything else is at the moment. So the reason that wasn't in the middle is because I know that it's much louder. So I'm going to turn it back down. It's a bit of a fairer comparison if they're about the same level. I mean, they all sound great, don't they? But they are all a little different. It's really nice to do this. Right, let's mess around with some drive. So yeah, that typical compressed kind of Tubescreamer tone there. The ODR one, little less mids. Still feeling a little compressed. Oh, that just sounds lovely. So beautiful. Right. More drive, please. Got quite a bit louder again there as well, isn't it? So even on full drive, there's some nice dynamics to be found there. Which I think's quite true for most of these. This one's probably the most compressed. So yeah, just going for dynamics with playing there. I'm not touching the volume control on the guitar at all. Go to the bridge pickup on this telly. Right, let's try and match these levels a little bit better. Oh, I think that's a little better. Right. There we go. Really interesting, the difference in the mids, because that's kind of where all the difference is sitting. Yeah, you know, there's a little bit difference in the kind of gain, not the gain staging, but the nature of the gain, the overdrive. But it's just all in those mids, isn't it? And how much compression there is. Right, let's have a little mess around with some of the tone controls on these. So I'm going to go back around. Just dial back some of that drive. It's all a bit over the top at the moment on full. Right, so tone. Let's just whack it right up. And see how they sound. So back to the neck pickup. I think that sounds awesome. Right, let's go back. Still on bridge. Don't they all sound great, man? If you have to just choose one of these, which one would it be? Let me know in the comments. I mean, they're just all brilliant, aren't they? Such classics for a really good reason. Let's boost this volume and see what we can get out of pushing the tubes in the amp. So using them more of a clean push. So I'm gonna take some of the gain off, right? Typical kind of legs akimbo style push from the Tubescreamer. Let's do a similar thing on all of them actually. Right, we know that the Klon seems to have a higher output anyway, so I'm not gonna put that all the way across. Let's see what happens. Right. This is just the amp again. You can hear that pushing the tubes a bit there. Lovely. I really like that. That's lovely as well. Right, let's boost the volume, see what happens. Still really dynamic, I really like this pedal. Yeah, still really dynamic. As is that. As is that, to be fair, played like this. Increase the gain on it. It's much more compressed if the pedal's providing the gain, but if you use it as a more of a clean boost, there's an interesting point. Right. Absolutely amazing. The Klon. Let's push it with the ODR. Wow. Okay, let's push the Klon to the Tubescreamer. Unsurprisingly, more nasal, but that would cut through the mix brilliantly, wouldn't it? Let's push the ODR with the Tubescreamer. Well, I could do this all night quite happily. Three different characters in there. Boosted mids, slight mid hump. Really dynamic. Not as dynamic if relying on the gain to provide the dirt, as it were, rather than pushing the tubes of the amp. But again, using it as a cleaner boost, pushing the tubes of the amp, plenty of dynamic still. So pick your poison. You can't go wrong. They're all amazing. Quick game, I'm sure you know the answer. Most expensive to the cheapest, what do you think? Yeah. So I'm sure you can work that one out. Right, let's leave it there. Really interested in your comments. Post them below. Which one did you prefer? Why? Which one did you think was the most dynamic, most interesting sound, nicest kind of gain structure? Whatever floats your boat, let us know. All right, take care. See you soon.